Welcome back everyone to the last video about the safe operation configuration in KUKA.Sim. Again, the short disclaimer, make sure to read the product documentation and to verify your results on WorkVisual and then test them on the real robot before doing the safety acceptance test. In this last part of the sequence, we're going to talk about the export from KUKA.Sim to WorkVisual of your safe configuration and then also about the KUKA Stop Services, how to activate them and how to use the information that you get there. So again, let's go back into the tool. We did already the whole configuration last time in the two previous videos about the cell area, the tools, the monitoring spaces and everything else. So now if you click here on Export Project, you can browse for the folder that you want to put it in and then click here on export. It will take a little while, so I actually did it up front. So once you open the folder and use WorkVisual, you get here to actually the overview of your cabinet and the controller and the robot. And if you click on plus and on safety controller here, it will actually open you a yellow window. And here you will have the whole overview of your cells. So first the name and then the activation code and the end also the, if you go to global parameters, you have the whole overview here as you configured it in KUKA.Sim. Also here for the overview of the cell configuration, we have our 5 points. And we have our protected space and our workspace and our access specific space. So as we did it in KUKA.Sim. In addition to that, we have all the other config, our tool for instance here. So if we go on that, we'll see all the spheres. And this is, comes in really handy because from here you can export it then to your robot and use it for real. Now let's get back to KUKA.Sim. Here we have another really interesting tool, which is KUKA Stop Services. When you select a robot and click on it, there's an option package opening here. And here you can actually first choose which start and stop end position should be used. So for instance, I can use my two home positions right here. And the sampling rate, I'm going to leave it at 250 milliseconds. And once I start this, it creates spheres or point clouds around my tool, which tells me where the robot would stop in case of a stop zero, for instance. So if all the power is cut, where would the robot stop? And I can see, okay, in the worst case scenario, if my robot is here and there's a blackout or something, the robot might crash into the fence. But in addition to that, once I configure, I don't know, a little smaller sampling rate, and I use only the deviation path down here, I deselect the safety tool and the swept volume, and I run again the program, which is actually just a dummy program going to the reference point on the brake test over here, as you can read it there. And I run this again, I can also see here a little dotted line in different colors. And actually the robot tells me how is the deviation of the path. And here I selected the colors, for example, down here, I might be fast and therefore I deviate a little bit more than 300 millimeters from the actual path that I wanted. This can come also in really handy if you have fast movements and you don't want to crash in anything. You can double check it here. And of course there's this handy button to reset all the settings and you can start all over again. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, write them below in the comments and hope that I helped you to configure your cell and hope to hear from you soon in another video. Until then, bye.
industrial intelligence.